All right, what's going on, guys? We back with another reaction video, review, reaction, whatever you want to call it. We checking out the new Arctis Gamebuds from Steelseries. They just dropped not too long ago. They were probably, I don't know when they were announced, but I just found out about them a few days ago from a buddy of mine. I need to start following. I started following Steelseries after that because I thought I was following them, and I guess not. I'm a fan of theirs. For those that don't know, I have the Nova Pros, the Nova Pro wireless ones, and then had the Arctis Pro wireless ones before that. Great headphones. I love the wireless aspect of them. Have never had any issues with them. Aside from the fact that they're the cup ones, obviously. And, you know, from there I, like, moved on to some earbuds. For those that don't know what earbuds I was rocking the Sony InZone Buds. Good earbuds. Not to take away from SteelSeries or anything. Worked really good on the console, but for what I needed them for, they just weren't doing the job. Had issues with the support, not getting any support from them. Complete morons, by the way. But that's beside the point. We want to be able to stream via capture card on our PC from the PlayStation 5, which is a headache itself, especially for gaming, for wireless gaming. As you guys might know that are in here, me and my buddy have been trying to figure out ways to workarounds and everything. I've tried to contact customer support, see if there's any workarounds. Everything's just difficult. And obviously wasn't having any luck. Sony, the InZone Buds, they work, like I said, they work great on the console. No issues, really good sound. But as soon as I connect the dongle to the PC and capture card the audio from my PlayStation to my PC, the earbuds, for whatever reason, were disconnecting. Even though they were connected to PC, for whatever reason, they would just disconnect simultaneously, like, between earbuds. And it was really annoying to play, first-person shooters. You guys know me. I play a bunch of PUBG. That's all I play, really, aside from, like, some side mission story games occasionally. But, yeah, just really annoying. Just trying to stream and play, like, having some good games and, you know, very competitive. So when you lose, like, hearing out of one ear, like, ruins the gameplay for you. Making an unfun experience, but... Yeah, man, I got these, what are they called? Arctis Gamebuds? Yeah, Arctis Gamebuds. And like I said, had really good history with the headphones, over-the-ear headphones. The only reason I ever changed was because of me wanting to play with buds. But yeah, sounds like they finally decided to join the server with... with their earbud design. And here we are. Checking them out. So, I did a previous recording, but I had to, like, get rid of it. I had a hard time. I was trying to, like, configure everything so I can have it set up. So, I just did it offline. But without further ado, let's get into it. This is what you're getting. Obviously, the dongle's missing from here. But it fits in perfect. These don't fall out or anything. Somebody mentioned that it felt a little cheap on the case. The case can be cheap, but I don't have any issues dropping my stuff, so it's not going to be an issue for me. They seem pretty secure, though. But, yeah. So, first initial thoughts off on that. They work fine for... They work great for me as far as, like, the case. It's not a big problem. One thing to note, these have, like, wireless charging. You can put these on a platform that does charging, and they'll charge. So really cool feature that the Sony Endzones don't have. So you don't even have to like plug them in through USB. That's one free USB that you don't need in your on your PC. And I use a lot of USBs, so it's nice to see. So I might have to pull out my old charging station for that. But yeah, excuse me. You also get extra ear tips that come in this box, along with a USB stick that's an adapter for the what do they call that? USB-C. Where's? Did I put them in here? Okay. So, like, that part, the USB-C, I think is what, I'm pretty sure that's what that's called. Which is how you plug them in anyway. But, that's connected to the back of the PC currently. Didn't want to, like, have to mess with everything again. What else do you get? Obviously, the charging cable, and like I said, as I said, the tips, I think they come with larger ones and then they come with small ones. I think I just have the standard ones. But without further ado, let's get jump into it. So these are the buds. They look kind of small, if I'm being honest. Oh, I'm getting double audio now. The product itself is light. Let me mute that. It's one thing I've already noticed that I don't care for. These things, the mic will turn on right away. I don't know if there's a feature to turn it off. But for now, like, I have changed the setting already. You just plug them in. I'll be honest with you. These fit way better in your ear than the other one, like my like Sony's. Basically just, like, they're so snug. You put them in, kind of like twist them a little bit, and they like lock in. Like, you don't get like, in a previous video that I saw, like, you could like, the way they like flush with your ears, like you can kind of lay with these and they probably wouldn't fall out of your ear at all. If you're doing like audiobooks and stuff like that. Another cool feature, they're Bluetooth compatible. They work with any cell phone device, iPhones included. They're not like that LE specific like the Sony Endzones, so they already like win in that category. they're not touch. They're not touch. They actually have a button, like buttons on these, that you can soft press. So that's another cool feature, where everything else is like touch, like you have to touch it and stuff like that. It's super sensitive. My buddy said that they were sensitive, but I haven't noticed it yet. I also changed the settings around. I know he was having issues with his settings because he got a different version, like an Xbox version, but I was able to go on my PC and change like the button layout. So instead of having like one touch on the right, be pause, play, I have it like double touch, or and instead like one touch like turns the volume up or down. But that's all personal preference, depending on how you want to do it. But yeah, so yeah, right off the rip, I don't know if, are you guys here? Okay, just want to make sure. Right off the rip, I like the feel of these. Like I said, they're comfortable. Don't know how long I can last yet playing, but we'll be able to test that in a separate video. But as of right now, I like the way they feel. Like I said, I like how they're snug in the ears and whatnot. My biggest thing, and I will be able to like do like a test or a update on the how I feel about them later, but. So far, no disconnecting issues. Then again, my Sony Endzone buds, I didn't have this issue for the longest time. It wasn't until after I told my buddy to get them where the issue started happening. He was experiencing it, and then eventually I started experiencing it. And then, like, the last firmware update, like, I was experiencing over and over, like, just constant, like, disconnecting. And it was so frustrating. Which is why I went back to my SteelSeries Nova Pros. But I've always, like I said, I've always enjoyed the SteelSeries products. Nothing bad to say about them all at all. I'm hoping that down the road, because one thing I will note with these, you don't get dual audio like you do with the Nova Pros or the Arctis Pros. Just to put that out there for those that are wondering, it's one or the other. You can change it on the go. Like if you're getting, you're connected to your phone, you can, and you get a call, like you can switch to it. I can't remember. There's this, it has pair on mobile, connected gaming device, quick switch wireless. So you can switch between 2.4 gigahertz and then you can switch to Bluetooth. So that's like your switch back and forth, but you can't have them connected at the same time. Through the PC though, you can do some like settings and whatnot. I've currently run Wavelink where all my audio goes through. So it allows me to listen to my music, listen to my game, listen to YouTube or whatever tab, Twitch, if you're watching somebody and whatnot. I can listen to everybody at once that way, but through different devices, it doesn't have that dual audio like the Arctis Pro and our Nova Pros. So keep that in mind when you get these. I'm sure down the road they will get more advanced and go that route. There'll be like a Arctis Pro Gamebuds version or something. But right now, like, they're testing the waters, you can tell. Because, like I said, these are their first Gamebuds, as far as I'm concerned. I'm pretty sure I'm correct on that. But, yeah. Let's do, like, some... Well, let me rephrase that. I don't know how the mic sounds on these. I would have to test it out. But from what I gathered, they're solid. If I'm not mistaken, the microphone on the Sony InZone Buds were pretty bad. Didn't sound that good. It was like the one default. Battery life on these is up to 10 hours on the Game Buds. But you get 30 to 40 hours charging on the actual charging case. Plus, like I said, it's wireless. It has the wireless charging capability, so you can put it on a charging station. So, how fast do they charge? I don't know yet. Like I said, these are brand new for me. I could put that in the update video if you guys want to know. But, yeah, I mean, so far from everything I've heard, these sound great. Let's just play some music for you guys. Just to do a live test real quick. So, I mean, So far, they sound really great. No complaints. I haven't messed with the equalizer settings. But I like the sound. They sound crisp. I don't hear any... Like, audio doesn't sound bad at all. It's about what I would expect. If I'm being honest, currently these sound closer to my Sony InZone buds than the Arctis Pro or the Nova Pro wireless ones were when I went back to them. Like, those sound like muffled. The sound sounds muffled on those right now. I don't have the sonar option on yet. Those that are familiar with Steelseries, these do have the sonar ability. I don't know if, I think that might just be a Steelseries thing in general, like, they can all have it. But, I'm not for sure. I'm not, like, the best Steelseries whiz or not, whatnot. I'd like to be. But, yeah, man, I mean, they sound great so far. We're gonna do, like... I have to be able to test these on console, but the sole purpose of me getting these was so I could hear it through my PC while gaming without them disconnecting. If they do that for me, then they've already done more than my other gaming buds are currently doing. And I mean, by default, like, I'm going to enjoy them a lot more. I'm going to be able to use them for a lot more as it is. Like I said, you can use these with your Apple products. It doesn't have to just be LE products only. For those that don't know what LE is, it's a specific Bluetooth. It's for like something efficiency, latency efficiency. I can't remember what it is. Like I said, I don't have them. I don't have products like that. Because Apple doesn't have that kind of feature. But... somebody could better answer that if I got that wrong. But it's like some special feature, basically. But yeah, I'm going to currently test some audio out. We're going to go to my PlayStation currently. And obviously, like, I'm not going to get the full experience of the console audio because I'm playing these through capture card to my PC. I'm on PUBG right now, so any audio I'm getting is going to be like that the audio set on my equalizer for my PC setup. And right now, like, the audio sounds fine. Like, I don't hear anything that makes me... What the? It just kicked me out? I'm not hearing anything that makes me, like, say, oh, these are a turn-off. There's no way I could play like this. But, that's just first reaction, honestly. Obviously, and, I mean, there's, like, a slight chance that I could be wrong. But obviously, like, these are gonna sound a lot better in this on the PlayStation. Just as I would expect. Like, I notice the difference when I have the Sony InZone buds plugged in to the PlayStation. I feel like there's a slight delay when I play them on PC. But like I said, you have to do this in order to stream on capture card. If you're streaming from the console, then it's a bigger plus for you. Like, you don't have to worry about that. But for us people that are capture card streaming from console to PC, you do get a slight smidge of a delay. And depending on how you react to it, like, you either got the reaction time or you don't. But it is something I did notice connecting the Sony InZone buds. And I'm sure there's a delay in when I'm playing on these two. But yeah, I mean, right now, like, it sounds great. Obviously, I do further testing, but I'm not gonna sit here and spend whole hour testing on the video or on this video though that I'm creating. But yeah, I like so far this is great. I'm getting left to right directional awareness. Let's get up to the. I want to get to the gunshots. Yeah, like I can tell this is coming left. Now it's on my right. That's this guy right here. Yeah, like. Even though the direct audio source isn't the PC or PlayStation, like I can still get the audio. I'm still getting the audio, like the signals from the lefty to the right. That's coming from over here. Oh, he's up there. I was like, where is this guy? Another place, like, for me, I got a cool feature. I can go and, have an audio-specific testing zone, testing ground. And my drift is terrible in this right now. I always have a hard time finding this one. Where is it at? Aim Sound Lab. Where is that at? Apparently I need to zoom in because I can't see. There it is. How do you... Can I not go in here? Having technical difficulties. There we go. So you can do like sound training. I know obviously this is not everybody's gonna have this because they're not playing this game, but just to further demonstrate. Obviously I'm. At least I'm still waking up. Yeah, see my motor skill. my senses aren't fully adaptive right now, but I can hear the audio. Just a cool little feature. But yeah, man, I mean, obviously right now, I haven't had any disconnecting problems, which is already a plus for my book. They still sound good, even though they're not connected to the actual source. Like I said, I could do another video where I connect it to the source, the PlayStation, where I'm getting the audio directly, but I already know, like, I know, I mean, let's just do it, honestly. We're here. We might as well, right? Connected. I like that the dongles, I like the feel of it. It's better than this is currently the Sony one, and it's kind of flimsy. It's kind of thin, like where this one's actually like bricky, which is better to my opinion. It's easier to access, like connect it. Why am I not hearing this? There we go. It's kind of quiet. Is it because my audio is... So you guys aren't going to hear this audio. It's a stupid feature. If I output device isn't on HDMI device TV, capture card won't pick up the audio. So you're not going to hear any game audio, but I'm going to further test the audio for you guys. They sound kind of low. I think the settings are still the same, so. All right, just grab the M4. One more thing. If you're gonna test the sound out, you gotta make sure you have the right sound, right? All audio, voice chat, 3D audio. Okay, it's on. Yeah. I'm gonna be honest with you. These actually sound pretty close. I don't know what it is, but the game audio doesn't sound that loud. Maybe it's a PUBG thing. Let's pull up Call of Duty real quick. Don't buy this game. It's ass. I'm just kidding. Okay, that was weird. Signed in as Blastoise. I've played this game for how long? Maybe a couple hours. What is going on? Might need an update. It might take a little minute. I know this video is being stretched out, but I want you guys to be able to hear what I'm hearing. And like, yeah, I just... I'm just not hearing, like, the audio just sounds quiet. Yeah. Honestly, I could tell the difference between the Sony InZone buds when they were connected, when one was connected versus the other. I can't. I can't hear. So putting these back in the PC. That's good though, because that means these sound just as good
as they do in the other one.
And that itself is a win in my book. Now, the true test is going to be like the duration, obviously. If I can get these to last the whole time I'm using them and not have them disconnected. Oh. See, right now. I'm hearing the audio. Or I'm hearing the mic. Right. Hold on. Better test would be to mute the Yeti. Make sure it's not coming there.
Hello? Oh, okay.
Yeah, so right off the rip, I can tell the microphone sounds pretty good. It doesn't sound bad like the end zones. So,
another dub.
Let's see what happens when I disconnect, when I pull one out. Still getting audio. Oh, damn it. I've had my speakers in the background playing the whole time. That's cool. That's how you know these videos are raw and real. Yeah. I'll just sum it up. These earbuds are so far a plus. Like I said, not experiencing any problems right now. Hopefully that continues, knock on wood. But right now, like, I'm enjoying these way more. Like I said, I liked the Sony in zone buds right off the rip. They were doing what I needed them to do, and then they like took a crap and stopped working where I needed them to work. Great headphones when they work on the console, but for whatever reason, when they're in PC mode on PC, like, they disconnect so much. Didn't experience the disconnecting right off, just in this session alone for the Steelseries Arctis buds. Hopefully that continues to not be the case down the road. But we'll further test. I will provide an update video. We'll give it as long as we can, but at the very latest, we'll do like a month. We'll check in a month. But right now, I'm satisfied. I was a little pessimistic about it because my buddy tried these first. He got the Xbox versions. He also has a PlayStation. I don't know. Like I said, it's all going to come down to whether these disconnect or not during sessions. So I'm really hoping that that doesn't happen. Fingers crossed, for all you guys that are in the same boat as me and my buddy, streaming from the console to a PC on capture card, trying to do your stream sessions with wireless earbuds or gaming headphones and whatnot. Trying to stay optimistic about that kind of stuff, you know what I mean? So right now, you can pick these up. They are going for $159.99. That's $40 cheaper than the Sony InZone buds are. And they're just as good, if not better. Make sure, I think it will matter, make sure you guys get the right set, right pair. There are two different versions. There's an Xbox version and a PlayStation version. You want to make sure you get the PlayStation version, because my buddy didn't, and I think he might be experiencing problems because of that, even though he doesn't think so. But just off comparing between us, I haven't had any issues like he has, so I feel a lot more optimistic going into my first stream session, whereas I wasn't when he was telling me his problems he was experiencing. So if you guys are looking for a setup video through capture card, let me know. I'll get you one set up. This will also help me down the road if I need to like go back and redo settings and whatnot. so I'll have it for myself. Maybe I'll just do it in general. But right now, this was a testing. This was a testing review type video for the SteelSeries. And right now, these are for sure a go-to. Definitely like them. Like I said, I like the feel, like how they feel, how they fit in your ear. They like lock in, and it doesn't feel like they're ever gonna fall out or whatnot. Even like if you were working out or whatnot, whatever. Like I said, because you can use any mobile device and it'll pair up pretty easily. But they seem to be snug. So if there's any questions you guys have in the comments, or post them in the comments, please. I'll try to answer them. But right now I'm satisfied and I am looking forward to future streams in gaming with these. But that's going to do it for this one. Appreciate you guys stopping in. Sorry, the video is a little longer. Apologies for the audio in the background for a good portion of the video. Hopefully it wasn't a turnoff. But with that being said, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.